The men who tipped off Indonesian authorities about the Bali 9 drug smugglers will give evidence at Scott Rush's death penalty appeal. 10 reporter Leonie Mellor is following the story and brings us this report from Bali.
Former Police Commissioner Mick Kelty will be the first to appear here in court in just a few hours' time. He'll be followed by the current Deputy Commissioner Michael Phelan. They'll be among five witnesses giving evidence in this next phase of Scott Rush's final appeal to beat the death penalty. Now, these two men were instrumental in delivering the Bali 9 into the hands of Indonesian police. Now they could be critical in saving the 24-year-old Scott Rush's life. Now, of course, Scott Rush was only 19 at the time of the drug smuggling attempt. He was initially sentenced to life in jail, but when he appealed against this sentence, was given the death penalty. Scott Rush won't be present to hear the two men give evidence this morning and to hear them say that he was only, in fact, a minor player in this scheme, not an organiser, that he wouldn't have known how big the operation was to be. While the AFP have been widely criticised for tipping off the Indonesian police, which saw the Bali 9 arrested here in Indonesia, both Mick Kelty and Michael Phelan have maintained that they acted legally and appropriately. And in fact, a federal court ruling also found this to be the case. Professor Andrew Burns from the University of New South Wales also is expected to give evidence, talking about whether the death penalty is justified. And there will also be two Indonesian legal experts who will be talking about entrapment and asking why Indonesian police waited until Scott Rush was at the airport to arrest him on these drug smuggling charges instead of arresting him at the hotel. Now, all these witnesses are expected to give their evidence today, but a final decision on whether the death penalty should be overturned is not expected for several months.